Video number 2, unit number 2, part number 2, his first flight, reading, first year, / grade 11, English KPK textbook 2020. The sun was now ascending, the sky, blazing, warmly, on his ledge, that faced the south. He felt the heat, because he had not eaten since the previous nightfall. Then he had found a dried piece of mackerel tail at the far end of his ledge. Now, there was not a single scrap of food left. He had searched every inch, rooting among the rough, dirt-caked straw nest where he and his brothers and sister had been hatched. He even gnawed at the dried pieces of spotted eggshell. It was like eating part of himself. He had then trotted back and forth from one end of the ledge to the other, his gray body the color of the cliff, his long gray legs stepping daintily, trying to find some means of reaching his parents without having to fly. But on each side of him, the ledge ended in a sheer fall of precipice, with the sea beneath. And between him and his parents, there was a deep, wide chasm, and above him he could see nothing. The precipice was sheer, and the top of it was perhaps farther away than the sea beneath him. He stepped slowly out to the brink of the ledge, and standing on one leg with the other leg hidden under his wing, he closed one eye, then the other, and pretended to be falling asleep. Still they took no notice of him. He saw his two brothers and his sisters lying on the plateau, dozing, with their heads sunk into their necks. His father was preening the feathers on his white back. Only his mother was looking at him. She was standing on a little high jump on the plateau, her white breast thrust forward. Now and again, she tore at a piece of fish that lay at her feet, and then scraped each side of her beak on the rock. The sight of the food maddened his beak now and again. To wet it, he uttered a low cackle. His mother cackled too, and looked over at him. "Gah, gah, gah," he cried, begging her to bring him over some food. "Gaula," she screamed back derisively. But he kept calling plaintively, and after a minute or so he uttered a joyful scream. His mother had picked up a piece of the fish, and was flying across to him with it. He leaned out eagerly, tapping the rock with his feet, trying to get nearer to her as she flew across. But when she was just opposite to him, abreast of the ledge, she halted, her legs hanging limp, her wings motionless, the piece of fish in her beak almost within reach of his beak. He waited a moment in surprise, wondering why she did not come nearer, and then, maddened by hunger, he dived at the fish. With a loud scream, he fell outwards and downwards into space. His mother had swooped upwards. As he passed beneath her, he heard the swish of her wings. Then a monstrous terror seized him, and his heart stood still. He could hear nothing, but it only lasted a moment. The next moment he felt his wings spread outwards. The wind rushed against his breast feathers, then under his stomach and against his wings. He could feel the tips of his wings cutting through the air. He was not falling headlong now. He was no longer afraid. He just felt a bit dizzy. Then he flapped his wings once and he soared higher. He raised his breast and banked against the wind. "Gah, gah, gah. Gah, gah, gah. Gaula." His mother swooped past him, her wings making a loud noise. He answered her with another scream. Then his father flew over him screaming. Then he saw his two banking and soaring and diving. Then, he completely forgot that he had not always been able to fly, and commenced himself to dive and soar and curvet, shrieking shrilly. He was near the sea now, flying straight over it, facing straight out over the ocean. He saw a vast green sea beneath him, with little ridges moving over it, and he turned his beak sideways and crowded amusedly. And around him, his family was screaming, praising him, and their beaks were offering him scraps of dogfish he has made. His first flight.